Tonight, stunning claims accusing HCA's Bannett Point Hospital outside Tampa, Florida, of putting profits over patients.
Have lives been lost, in your opinion, due to the behavior of HCA?
Absolutely, yes.
That's a very serious allegation.
It sure is.
Sounding the alarm, Dr. George Janikopoulos, who's been a neurosurgeon at the Level 2 Trauma Center for 29 years, elected the chief of staff there 10 times.
I love Bayonet Point. It's my home.
But since the pandemic, he says the for-profit company, HCA, has been cutting staff and corners. For example, firing the anesthesiology team and replacing them with what he says are generally less competent people, leading to many errors, including one of his patients waking up during brain surgery.
The patient was on headpins, which is a very sharp instrument that is put into the skull.
To hold the head steady.
To hold the head steady. And I was just shaving the head when the patient tried to get up. So you can imagine that could have been tragic.
So, I mean, that sounds like rank incompetence on the part of the anesthesiologist.
It sure is.
At an emergency meeting with hospital leadership in December of 2021, four doctors who were present say more than a dozen surgeons expressed widespread concern.
I asked the question, do you feel this hospital is safe? And it was a unanimous vote from the surgeons that it was not. Then I asked him another question. Is the hospital dangerous? And that was, again, a unanimous vote that the hospital was dangerous.
Neither the hospital nor HCA would agree to an interview, but they told us they take quality issues very seriously, that the hospital is appropriately staffed for the safety of patients, and that they are continually looking for ways to improve. But according to Dr. Janikopoulos and three other doctors who spoke to NBC News, things continued to get worse.
In January of 2022, we had 18 near misses in the operating room.
Which means these patients, their lives were put at risk by mistakes being made in the operating room.
Absolutely.
As for the ICU, documents from state regulators show an insufficient number of nurses. Two doctors told us they believe such staffing issues led to the unnecessary death of a man who came in with a headache, later diagnosed as an aneurysm. Unattended by nurses, he died before it could be repaired.
When we look at the notes, there was absolutely not a single nursing note for 12 hours.
Well, that's malpractice, isn't it?
It's beyond malpractice. This should not happen.
And there's more. These photographs provided to NBC by doctors show a shocking lack of cleanliness, from leaks in the ceiling, bloody and backed up sinks, to...
There have been many sightings of cockroaches. One of the cockroaches was alive, coming out of a tray that was presented to us from the sterile processing department.
And the problems are not just at Bayonet. According to the most recent federal data, 70% of HCA's 37 rated hospitals in Florida have a below average rating. It's not that HCA doesn't have money.
The HCA has generated $16.4 billion in profits over the last 3 years. And its CEO has received $78 million in compensation during that period.
I don't have a problem with a good business making profits and prospering. But when patients are dying because of your policies, I get a huge problem with that.
If someone at home right now about to be admitted to Bayonet Point, what would you say to them?
There are other choices. Go somewhere else.
Cynthia McFadden, NBC News, Hudson, Florida.
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Follow today's top stories and breaking news by downloading the NBC News app.